Welcome back
to Wild Taiwan.
Ooh la la!
I feel powerful on this thing. There's a lot of horsepower in a small package.
A lot of horsepower. Come back. It's not your ride.
I know. It's addicting. It's addictive. I see why. I see the appeal. I see it.
Well, this is Brian's, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
And this is Tim's. Mm. Your baby here.
It is. Yeah.
Oh, and you are like, you are dressed to the arm to the teeth in this thing.
Absolutely.
Man, this
safety first, right?
Exactly. Yeah. Always.
We'll talk about your baby here. Your girlfriend.
My baby. Yeah. My wife.
Yeah. Oh, wow. What about it?
It's a Suzuki Hayabusa.
Yes.
It's 1,300cc.
Mm-hmm.
I've had it for about 4.5 years, done lots of miles on it. It's a great way to get around and see the island, all within the speed limits, obviously.
Yeah.
And very comfortable. Most people in Taiwan think it's a bit too big for Taiwan.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Depends on where you go.
It does, it does. And
yeah.
What kind of riding you want to do. I mean, yeah. If you want to do the small switchbacks up in the mountains, then maybe it's not quite the right bike.
Right. You might need a dirt bike for that.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. It's a bit lighter, yeah, a little bit.
Really
more.
Tight corners there.
Exactly, yeah, exactly. Yeah. Get the back out.
So do you have your favorite or your secret route? Then?
Yeah. I have a few secret routes, but one of the ones I love the most is going uphill because there's so much power.
Yeah.
Going up a hill feels like you're just going, you know, when you go up on hill on a scooter, it's like,
yeah, yeah.
Take out the newspaper,
yeah. Yeah.
Drink
your coffee.
Exactly, exactly, have a cup of tea. Yeah. But with this, you go up hills just as fast as you do on flat land. So from Hualien, going up to Tehuansan, through Taroko, and the Taroko scenery is just amazing because,
I believe so.
You know, you look up and it's just as far as you can see of mountainous gorges and rocks, and then you look down, you've got beautiful rivers.
So it feels like you're flying almost.
Basically, like, yeah. And the more you go up, you get a difference and a contrast in the trees and the plants.
Right.
So down in the bottom in Hualien,
yeah,
it's all like tropical.
Different
and then you go up to Tehuansan, it's like,
it's
I feel like
magical.
I'm back in England.
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
All the trees are similar. And
yeah, the pine trees.
Exactly,
and
exactly. So you get a real contrast of the different kind of climates of Taiwan. And then you get to the top and it's a little bit cooler.
Right, right.
But then when you start to come down, it warms up and it's not too bad.
Oh, you'll remember to bring a jacket when you go to Tehuansan.
And some gloves, and yeah, I'm not going to do it Fumi style.
So, memorable trips.
Speaking of memorable trips.
Yeah.
Memorable trip was my Taiwanese friend.
Yes.
He's got the same bike as this. Mm-hmm. And I didn't have this at the time, so we shared his bike, which is this bike, but, you know, different.
So two
different
people.
One, but model, yeah, but two okay. People on the one bike. And we left Taipei at maybe 10 o'clock at night, and we were driving down to our friend's bike shop in Changhua. Mm-hmm. And we got down near to their bike shop, maybe 5 kilometers away. And I took the key out. I was riding, and my friend was on the back.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, let's fill up with gas, with petrol,
mm-hmm.
before we get to the shop, so in the morning we can just zoom off straight away.
Right.
We're all prepared, we're ready. He's like, okay, let's do that. So we get there and it's his bike and I've never opened the fuel tank before.
Uh-huh.
So I put the key in, I turn it to the left, I'm like, that's not turning. I turn it to the right, I'm like, oh, that's not turning. Must be the left. Turn it to the left.
Snap.
Snap.
Oh no.
Half of the keys in the fuel tank, half of the keys in my hand.
Oh.
And of course you can't start the bike with half a key.
Oh my god.
So we're 5 kilometers away from where we need to get to. So I had to push my friend on the bike, which will really raise nearly 300 kilos. And this was summertime at 2 o'clock in the morning. It's still like 32 degrees.
Oh,
and I had to push him 5 kilometers.
And you have to kind of get at a pretty good pace in order to keep it kind
to
of
keep
upright.
It, exactly,
yeah,
exactly.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Too unforgettable.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, wow.
So he calls me Gorilla Hands now whenever I, you know, go anywhere near keys or anything. He's like,
broke the key,
did you bring a spare key? Yeah, I've got three.
Oh, wow.
This is quite humorous.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's
yeah,
funny.
Yeah.
But we have a sad story.
Yeah.
Brian. Let's sit beside
you. Yeah, I feel like you need some company, man.
Let's sit beside you. Yes, we're listening. Okay. Yes.
Go, it's okay. Go on, let it out.
我有一个女朋友, 我在当兵, 每个台湾的男生, 一个一个, 每个台湾的男生都要当兵, 他兵变,
哎呀,
他兵变,
哎呀,
那我, 我从18岁拿到驾照的时候，我就很喜欢骑摩托车，所以呢，我就选择了一个旅程。那一次，我从基隆骑到了合欢山。
有带外套吗？
没有，跟他一样。
Fumi style 啊，
我穿了一个短袖，我就去了，也没有手套，什么都没有。
真的是失恋的人哎。
对啊，
状态不是很清楚，
很难过，很难过。可是当我 turn around 回来的时候，我觉得我的心情是很 peace。
真的吗？
对对对，所以从此之后，我高兴或者是我不高兴，我很开心我也骑车，我不开心我也骑车。
那你有回顾过这条路线吗？
有啊。
有吗？
结婚的时候。哎，
哦，把他补回来，
对，带不同的人再走一次。对，带老婆再走一次这样子。
And do you have a route that you recommend to our followers?
Yeah, our. Do you have like a? Whoa!
Oh, 这么快就出来了。Wow!
This one
called 小酒
snail。
烧酒花鸟，这个东西是我们当我们从每一次的东部旅行的时候必经的路线。
This is your trip？
对，我跟我的老婆。
OK，
这个就是沿途它很漂亮的风景，就是右边是山，左边是海。哇，右边是山，左边是海，对，很漂亮，很漂亮。
北就是北部，还
北部滨海公路，
滨海
台二。
OK，
台二线，
台二线，
对对对 ，Round the Dwarf is gorgeous, beautiful。
这个 really look scary，
很恐怖
，Yeah， 但是很好吃。
I mean, it kind of reminds me of this like food。
它后面有剪了一个洞。
Okay, so there's a hole in the back。
对，让你的在吸的时候有空气，不会 stuck。
所以从下面吸吗？
不是，从这个头吸。
对对对，就是
对，那你就吸出来。
好小一只哦。
Do you want more?
Yeah, a little bit spicy.
Yeah.
And
how is it?
Lots of garlic.
Lots of garlic. Did you get it?
我其实我不知道它叫做烧酒嘞，有没有酒？但是我从来没有醉。
He's over there drinking. How is it? Finally.
It's really tired. But
it's like a mouth workout.
This has been such a treat. I mean, I don't ride.I've never ridden.
I really feel like
I've been convinced. You guys really kind of turned my mind around. I should really just get the license out of the way and then get a motorcycle license. Maybe we could all go for a ride someday.
Oh, yeah.